it will no longer be free to pollute anywhere in Canada.
In 2018, the federal government announced that every province and territory must implement a carbon pricing system this year. The move follows a commitment to greenhouse gas reduction targets that the Trudeau government signed in 2015. Since then, it has faced resistance from some provinces, particularly Saskatchewan and, more recently, Ontario, following the election of Doug Ford as premier. But what exactly is carbon pricing? It can take a couple of forms, a cap-and-trade system or a carbon tax. A cap-and-trade system sets a limit on the amount of carbon that companies are permitted to burn. That's the cap part. It also offers the option for companies to buy the right to burn more than their quota by purchasing allowances, also known as carbon credits, from companies that burn less. By doing this, they exchange their right to emit greenhouse gases. That's the trade part. The government makes money on those allowances because it auctions off a certain percentage of them. It also provides free allowances to some companies that face competitive pressure. A carbon tax is different from cap and trade. It's a fee imposed on each ton of emissions from fossil fuels. That includes oil products such as gasoline and diesel, natural gas, and coal-fired electricity. Under this system, everyone who buys a product that creates greenhouse gases pays for their emissions. Companies also pay, but those that face competitive pressures get a special break. Both a carbon tax and cap and trade have the same goal: to give companies and individuals a financial incentive to reduce their emissions.